Notes 8a. Solving quadratic equations. Objective. I can solve quadratic equations with and without technology. Essential question. How do I solve a quadratic equation? Let's review the zero product property. If the product of two real numbers is zero, then at least one of the numbers is zero. So we set the factors equal to zero separately to get our two solutions, our two zeros. Let's review solving a standard form equation with the calculator. So on your TI Inspire, here's your C Polyroots instructions. You press Calculate, Menu, 333. Be sure to put X at the end of the expression. And don't put that equals zero. If it's something other than equals zero right here, you must move everything to one side until it equals zero. So let's go to our calculator and we click Calculate. From there, you're going to press Menu, 3 Algebra, 3 Polynomial Tools, 3 complex roots of polynomial. Menu 333. You have something that says C polyroots. So you go ahead and type in your expression. 2x squared minus 9x minus 5. And we do not put equals 0. We do not do that. Instead, we put comma x. Enter. These are your zeros, these are your solutions. Let's just say we did put equals zero by accident. It will have an error. It says variable not defined. So don't do that. Put comma x instead. Your solutions are negative 1/2 and 5. So we write that on our paper. X equals negative 1/2 and 5. The factors would be x plus 1/2 and x minus 5. But remember, we need to slide that denominator to the front to make it 2x plus 1 times x minus 5. That's your factors. Okay, let's move on. Solve by taking square roots. 3x squared minus 75 equals 0. Step 1, we want to move the constant to the other side. So add 75 to both expressions. Not to the x, though. Only on each side of the equal sign. This is 0. And 0 plus 75 is just 75. We want to get x by itself still. So we want to divide by that 3. So it will not be there. 3 divided by 3 is 1. So 1x squared equals 25. To get rid of a square, we take the square root. The square root of x squared is just x. And then the square root of 25 plus or minus 5. That is our solutions. We have two solutions, x equals 5, x equals negative 5. Let's do the other equation. X squared minus 16 equals 0. First, we will add 16 to both expressions. 16 minus 16 is 0. Carry down the x squared. 0 plus 16 is 16. To get rid of a square, we take the square root. When we take the square root of a number, we put plus or minus in front. The square root of x squared is x. The square root of 16, 4. So x equals plus or minus 4. Let's review simplifying radicals, specifically square roots. Or try to factor out negative 1, 4, 9, 25, and 49. So let's do square root of 12. There's no negative, so we can't take out negative 1. However, we can divide by 4. 12 divided by 4 is 3. There's nothing else we could take out. The square root of 4 is 2. So our answer is 2 times the square root of 3. The outside numbers will be on the side, and the numbers left over that are multiplied are the last layer of this cake. Let's do square root of 180. There's no negative, but you can divide out 4. 180 divided by 4 is 45. This is an odd number, so we definitely can't take out any more even numbers. We can take out 9, though, so let's divide by the square root of 9. 45 divided by 9 is 5. There's nothing else we could take out, and so let's find what our answer is. Square root of 4 is 2, square root of 9 is 3. 3 times 2 is 6. So our simplified radical is 6 square root of 5. The last example is about using the quadratic formula. X squared minus 6x plus 3 equals 0. So first we want to identify A, B, and C. A is how many x squareds there are. There's 1 x squared, so A is 1. B, how many x's are there? There's negative 6. That's the coefficient B. Coefficient C is our constant, that's plus 3. Plug them into the formula. Recall from earlier in your notes, this is the quadratic formula. X equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Let's plug those in. B goes right here, that's a minus 6. B goes right here too for b squared. For a is 1, c is 3. All over 2 times A. Let's simplify these and rewrite. Negative times negative is a positive. So we have 6 plus or minus negative 6 times negative 6 is 36. Minus 4 times 1 is 4. 4 times 3 is 12. All over 2 times 1, which is 2. Let's simplify further. 36 minus 12. We have the square root of 24. And rewrite everything else. We can simplify the square root of 24. Let's go ahead and do that. The first perfect square we could take out is a 4. 24 divided by 4 is 6. Oh, 6 is one of those numbers you can't do anything else to. So we just have 2 square root of 6. Let's rewrite that. X equals 6 plus or minus 2 square root of 6 all over 2. At the top, the greatest common factor of 6 and 2 is 2. So we can factor out a 2. 6 divided by 2 is 3. 2 square root of 6 divided by 2 is the square root of 6. All over 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1, so those go away. So your solutions are x equals 3 plus or minus the square root of 6. That's it.